Whoa. Is this real gold?
I wonder how much I could sell it for. Hello, everybody, and welcome back. Today, we're going to talk about the processor. So what is a processor? I mean, we use the term so often. It's like how horsepower is used to define how good a car is. It's like, this phone is a quad core, this phone is a dual core, this system is a quad core, this system is an octa core. We say it so often, but do we really know what it means? I was thinking the same. So I decided it was time to do a little research. Oh, hey there. Well, I was just doing a little research. Except, you know, this is not a real book. Although, maybe I should write one. Million Dollar Idea Number 99. Write an awesome book. Totally original, bro. Never been done before. Yeah. So let's understand processors. So basically, I split this video into four parts. So part one is, what does a processor do? Well, mainly, like the name suggests, it does the job of processing or calculating or rendering something that is on the screen. That was so not obvious. Like, I totally did not get that from the name. Processor, processing. Brilliant! Well, speaking from a gaming perspective, it has the job of loading or rendering everything that is in the environment. So if you're playing something small, like an online game with a small map, the processor does not have a lot of work to do. So you can just load it once, and the GPU can do the job of making it look beautiful. But on the other hand, if you're playing something huge, like say Assassin's Creed or Grand Theft Auto, where the world almost seems unending, the processor is under continuous load, where every time you move into a new area, the processor has to keep working and loading that area. So that's why when you're playing some games, you'll notice that when you go into an area too fast, you'll probably see like a jittery image that loads up and becomes crispy after some time. This happens because you may not have a very powerful processor that can keep up with the speed of the game. But that brings us to the question, how does it do it? And that is point number two. So basically, there are two things that you should know. The processor cores and the speed. So we've all obviously heard dual core, quad core. It basically means 2 cores, 4 cores, 6 cores, 8 cores, blah, 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 blah. And the second thing is core clock speed, which basically is in terms of gigahertz. 3.7 gigahertz, 2.1 gigahertz, 3.5, 4.1, crazy numbers, right? So how do these work? Well, for this, we're going to use the example of Cinebench. This is a benchmark app. Now, although I don't rely on benchmarks very much because I believe these are just numbers and not real-life performances, but the way this works can be a good explanation. So in Cinebench, as you can see, there are a few yellow squares that are rendering an image. So basically, those yellow squares represent the number of cores that your processor has, and how fast that image renders in one square is actually the clock speed. So that kind of shows how multi-core processors work. I mean, think about 10 years ago, you'd buy a PC that had a single-core processor. Now, we don't buy a phone that is dual core. We don't want anything below quad core. So that brings us to point number three, is why we need multi-cores. So to make this simple, we're going to use a gym reference. I meant a gym reference. So let's think about a dumbbell. Now, if you have to lift a dumbbell, one hand is enough because, you know, it's small, you can easily lift it and you get the job done. But on the other hand, if you have to use a barbell, it's much wider and it's much heavier. So you need to use two hands. Unless you're super strong like this woman. She's good. Respect. So that's kind of how cores work as well. The more hands you have, the more lifting you can actually do and the more load it can actually take. And that brings us to our fourth and final point, is how to select a processor. So you must be thinking, oh, well, now I know it. I'll just see how many cores it has and what clock speed it has and I'm sorted and let's go, let's end this video. No. Sadly, it's not that simple. You cannot decide what you want by just comparing them on papers because real life performance actually varies a lot. The kind of explanations that I've given here are very simple to explain a very complex subject. I mean, processors are really complex and I just try to bring it down to a very simple level. So when you actually think about the real life performance of these, it is completely different. I mean, let's consider the i3 by the Intel, which is a dual core, and the FX6300 by AMD, which is a 6-core processor. Now, you'd obviously say that the 6-core should definitely win, right? You can check out the video by Science Studio where he compared these two processors. The link to that video will be in the description and in the I button. you can see that how the i3 was actually more powerful than the 6-core AMD. The only place where the AMD actually beat the i3 was in Cinebench. Now, unless you plan to run Cinebench on your PC 24/7, then you can buy the AMD. Otherwise, the i3 being a dual core was actually more powerful. Now, if you're an AMD fan, you may argue that, you know, it's a 4-year-old processor and whatnot, but that's not what we're talking about here. It's just about how the processor is more powerful even though it's a dual core. And that's not just the case only with PCs. In fact, even for phones, if you see the iPhone 6s, which is only dual core, actually beat the Note 7, which comes in quad cores or even octa-core. And for that, you can actually watch the video by Phonebuff, who, FYI, does the best speed test ever. The link to that video will be, you guessed it, in the description and the I button. Definitely go check these videos out. So finally, how do you determine how good a processor is? Sadly, it's not really possible to determine them just by reading about it on paper. You'll have to go to YouTube and watch videos about these processors and compare them to each another to finally find out which one is actually good. So now, obviously, there's a lot to talk about processors, but I hope you learned a little something from this small video. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button. Comment and let me know your thoughts about this video and what you'd like to see next. And definitely, do not forget to subscribe. Until next time, goodbye.